At one point, speaks again as a sophomore, making his varsity debut. And as in the other field events, each competitor receives three choices. They total the best choice, they add it up, and then the winnings are determined by the system. Irving McGraw, which we just had glimpses of, the Olympic team finished sixth. Not a fair exchange for the Elizabeth team. And if the point basis is based for the total team championship, using a scale of 10, 8, 6, 4, 2, and 1. So each place is a significantly important for the overall team championship. Now that was about 80 feet, and Bruce cannot be too happy with that pass. The officials are marking it by looking at the stakes. It was about 80 feet. He has thrown about 120 in practice. And here is Torin Devlin, also in the district team. And Torin in practice in some of the dual meets has practiced up to about 125. Up there, as the officials mark, and now again, there is a circle. As you step to the front of the circle, it is judged the foul. Competitor in the district team is Arnez Johnson. Now, Torin's first pass was out there, it was at 110 feet. Now, Arnez has popped the javelin consistently in 130 range, and Coach Costello and Coach McManus are helping Arnez to peak to about 9, and getting it out during the 150 range, which could place him up into the top players in the state. Okay, the officials are getting ready to mark that. That is about 140 from where the mark is standing. Scott Plains will go on to win the district competition. Westfield finishes second. Elizabeth finishes third. And again, Coach McManus and Coach Costello have to be pleased here with the district throwers. We're now ready for the running program of the Union County Boys Relay. And the first running program, again on the running program, is the 400 intermediate hurdle. Each settled into second place. Now, looking over the competition from the vantage point up here, Westfield has to be rated as a favorite, Raleigh, Union, and Elizabeth. Has settled into a good pace here, coming around the final turn. And Delk making a move for the lead. As the railway runner holds on, the Union runner is maintaining his third position. Now there goes Delk to the outside, moving ahead of the railway runner. The railway runner's coming back on him, though, just a bit. But maybe Delk made his move a little too early. To the fourth back turn, to the time exchange. Derek is kicking in the last 200. There is a team of cheering on the sides here. There is Derek Peters taking the last 50 past the railway runner to the first time exchange. He directs another sophomore, William DeVane. And there is a team exchange in William DeVane. A 52-53 quarter runner takes off. The railway is in second, Union is in third. This is a pure all-out sprint by William DeVane. And Coach Dave Costello has to be happy with his youngsters. Well, they were superstars on this team. The backbone appears to be a very solid group of sophomores and juniors. And here's William kicking in the final 50 to the Taconic Stone to the three-quarter race. And here he will pass the baton to senior captain Eric Robbins, who runs a 3:15 to 3:20 three-quarter race. Okay, Union has moved into second place. Now, this is to be a good competition here. The Union farmers have developed a very solid track program over the past couple of years, with a number of strong cross-country runners continuing through the indoor and right out the outfield track. Coach Bob O'Dell, one of the senior members of the coaching fraternity, has produced a very large number of solid distance runners. Now, this one is not over yet. Now, Eric is completing his first lap of three, and the Union runner is no more than 10 yards behind. So it looks like it's going to be a competition between Elizabeth and the Union. Now, let's get back here now. Watch Eric complete his two laps. Has to be happy with the distance medley team, especially after the disaster split, the 4x100 relay team. All it takes is one little mistake on the speed event and disaster strike. Completing his second lap. Thank you. this team has to be favored also in the high jump, with all three jumpers having scored 6 feet consistently in practice, and Sam Brown coming off the indoor season, jumping 6'8". And a tall setup about 5'10". And we have a number of jumpers from the other schools competing now. Okay, we're getting ready now for the 110-high shuttle hurdle. Once again, each runner running 110 yards over 10 hurdles. The fastest time decides the winner. The other team consists of Paul Moore, Ron Lockley, John Graham, and middle distance runner Jean Destine. All right, we're getting ready for the start. Official giving the command. The wind has picked up here. Okay. Here's the gun. That's John Graham running leadoff, with Westfield and Union on the far outside. John Graham leading. That's Ron Lockley running second. And the Elizabeth team is way out in front. Could be a neat record run here today. This is middle distance runner Gene Destine, who comes in and pitches in on the 110 shuttle hurdle team. Here's the closer, Torin Moore. State Group 4 champion last year as a junior in the 110 high hurdle. And Torin is coasting into the finish as Elizabeth dominates the 110 high hurdle. The Plainfield finishes second, and Union finishes third. The next varsity event on the track is the 4x200 relay. Early in the season here, but Elizabeth has run 130 for this relay. Here's the gun. That's Tommy Orr running leadoff. Now up the turn, it's Thomas Orr in the front. Now, disaster struck at this baton exchange zone earlier. Let's see what happens here. That's John Graham. Oh, there's another baton slippage. And John Graham successfully holds on this time, and he extends the lead. Unless they drop the baton here, Elizabeth is going to sweep to another gold medal. Off the 110 high hurdle, running third leg on the 4x200 UOA team. As he bends into the turn, he is way out in the lead. And there'll be no catching the anchor person. That's Ron Jones taking the baton exchange. And Ron is just sliding to the finish line off the back turn to the straightaway. About 20 yards to go, it's Ron Jones coasting to victory in the 4x200 relay. Distance metal. orderlies on there earlier in the morning, and he has settled into second place here. Westfield in the lead, Coastguard in third place, followed by New Providence in the yellow and green. Eric now has moved to the lead, Coastguard coming on the outside, and New Providence trailing. Eric is going to attempt to triple in this meet. He will come back later and run a mile on the 4 mile relay team. And that's a pretty hard thing to do. Running a mile, a 3/4 on the distance medley, and a hill up here in the 2 mile relay. That's Elizabeth in the lead. Westfield on the outside. Westfield Runner is making a move here. And he's thinking past Eric. Now Eric's got to be a little tired, having run a 3/4 earlier on the distance medley. That's Westfield in the lead. Elizabeth in second. Eric is making an attempt to come back. He's sprinting to the finish line. Now, Eric gives 110% every time he steps out on the track. A vast improvement over last year. And that's a platonic change to Junior Lewis Rivera. Elizabeth is in the lead. Lewis is a transfer in from Central. And he has added some depth to distance team here out of Elizabeth. He's running in first. Westfield running in second. The Providence has moved into third place, and Hillside is in fourth. This is one of a few sections here in the 2 mile relay. And again, places are based on time. The team is predominantly underclassmen. Lewis, a junior. Junior Jose Diaz will run next. And the anchor will be sophomore Derek Peters. With less than one lap to go now, it's Lewis Rivera. And Westfield is in second. Now, looks like the Westfield runner is beginning his move off the back team. And going down the back straightaway, Westfield runner moves to first.
Mendez is a senior.
Prince and Soul and Host Island Sports. Now Derek is beginning to look back, but either shows the two screens, either he's tired, or he's just trying to catch a glimpse of where his competition will be coming from. He notices that there's no one in sight, so he will just more or less just run a very steady pace to the finish line to win the silver medal for Elizabeth in the 2 mile relay. And Coach Tuck, though, once again, has to be pleased with his young group of Elizabeth's distance runners who have performed so well here at the Union County Boys Relay Championship. This is a two-team event where everyone is contributing. Every place, every point counts towards the team championship. And as Derek Peters crosses the finish line, Elizabeth finishes second in the 2 mile relay. Left field with Dan Abersonson wins it. And here we have is the Sales running the 2 mile relay team. And we'll take some time here to watch the girls compete. The next event up for the boys will be the 4 mile relay team. Each boy running 4 times or a mile. And that's a true test of endurance to have 4 young men on the team to run a respectable mile. Normally, schools get 1, 2, or 3 competitive miles. And at the baton exchange, Elizabeth was in the lead. Now is now moving over to the high jump where Elizabeth Semper, Tyrone Brown, will attempt 6 feet. Now Tyrone is competing primarily on his athletic ability. And he's well up. He was well over, but just kicked the ball. From our vantage point up here atop the press box, it looks like Tyrone had that with the ease, but he attacked it with his heel. It was Ron Lockley attempting the same height. As Ron approaches the ball, up, he hits it going up also. He's shaking his head. He was well over the bar. Now, Elizabeth will go on to win this competition. That was Sam Graham. Three misses by the three Elizabeth jumpers. As I said, since we're on, they take the late cases here. Elizabeth will go on and win this high jump competition. Here we are now in the 4 mile relay team. And this is Danny Sebastio, again, one of the promising sophomore runners. A leading runner for Elizabeth. We have a freshman runner from Westfield in second, and Union in third. And that will probably be the competition right there. completing their most difficult weapon. And knowing that, well, in hand, that Destine, coming on down with Union in second. Mignonis still having a good show here. This is the quarter age. Gets up to Grizz. Union has moved into the lead. Elizabeth is in second. A junior has come on this year. Coming to the last 100 in turn, it's Union in first, Elizabeth in second. It's Union, Elizabeth in second. At the Pecan Exchange, Union will be in the lead. As Abdul Batten the sixth. Destine, the premier Elizabeth distance runner, has two laps to make up the difference. Yelling instructions out here from the near side. The team closed down the gap in half already before the completion of the first turn. And there goes Destine on the taking the lead. Now we'll see whether or not he moved a little too early. Team Destine possessing 60-point quarter speed. He runs a half at 2 minutes or under, and he runs a 4:28 mile. Destine, well in command now here. As Elizabeth goes for the third once again. Left the back turn, it's Jean Destine. Good with Stan there, nice walk to six. Team Destine running away from the competition. We have a clock up here at the press box level on Dean. And the time he took the baton at the finish line to the time he's going to finish, it's close to being a flat 2 minute half mile. Yeah, mile. Which is close to being Dean's personal best for the year. As Elizabeth wins the varsity sprint medley. That's more or less icing the team championship for the Elizabeth unit win. They successfully have defended their championship. We're over here at the high jump now with Sean Green. I believe the ball's up at 6'7". Elizabeth having already won the team championship. Sean is going for personal best here. Sean just missed at 7. He had enough height. He just shifted with his heel. This is John's final attempt to 6 jump. Once more, he'll attempt 6'7". And the only other event, 18 events. This event takes total concentration. Sometimes outdoors, like indoors. It's the speed into height, the conversion. John misses at 6'7". A little disappointed that John has to get has competed in a number of events. The mile relay team. We have senior Ron Lockley running the lead off. Ron midfield and left field, running in the middle section. We have a tranquil runner on the outside. Don't care, Antonio Rivera. But Antonio makes an attempt to come back. But the difference here is the experience and maturity as the playing field runner. Antonio Rivera, and running after here, we have sophomore William Devine, who earlier ran on the gold medal winning distance medley. Hey, running after for the Westfield Blue Devils is Steve with Dan Avis. This is going to be an interesting battle here for fourth place. It's William Devine, and Danny Avis is kicking. And he's going to go right by William Devine. You can see him in the action. That's Danny Avis. Again, the experience and the strength of the Blue Devils senior runner just runs by William Devine. That's going to be it from Hepstown Field. Good night, Flip fans.
The national final. In fact, oddly enough, four of the scores are very similar. And for Duke, East regional champions, including one of the classics, the victory against Kentucky in overtime. And now, let's introduce the starting